In order to have greater road illumination, we have to put up with the glare caused by modern LED headlights. Or at least, this is what most people think. So, in this video, let me show you why this is a fallacy. Road illumination is a factor of luminous flux, so the total light power emitted by the light source, and how that light is distributed on the road, which is called the beam pattern and which is quite tightly regulated. But the same beam pattern can be achieved from two equally powerful lamps, one with smaller luminous surface, and that one is going to have higher luminance. Luminance is the intensity of light in a given area viewed from a given angle, and this is what we generally perceive as brightness. And therefore, this is also what is the main factor behind glare. So in this comparison, we have an identical illumination outcome, but the smaller lamp is going to be more glaring. This is what we also see, for example, in the Unified Glare Rating Index. So the size of the luminous area also contributes to glare, but luminance contributes exponentially. So if we decrease the size of the lamp while keeping luminous flux constant, then we increase luminance, and because of that, eventually we increase glare because, again, luminance contributes exponentially. So over the decades, we've seen that car headlamps not only become more powerful, but they also gradually decreased in size, especially with the introduction of projector optics. And both of these factors increase luminance and thereby increase glare. But note here that the decrease in the size of the luminous surface has nothing to do with road illumination. It has no perceptual advantages for the driver, but it has disadvantages for everybody else through the increase in glare. And the situation is actually much worse, and here's where it becomes really interesting. Across the luminous surface of the lamp, different light sources create a different light intensity distribution, and LEDs inherently lead to higher peak brightness. Thereby, all else being equal, they will always be more glaring. So how does this work? A halogen or HID light source can be modeled quite precisely as an ideal point source. So light leaves an ideal point source uniformly in all directions of space. So this is in two dimensions, but imagine a three-dimensional uniform sphere of light around the light source. And this is not how LEDs produce light. They already, without any optics, create a beam of light, and at the central axis of this beam, intensity is highest, and it falls off quite quickly as we look at larger angles away from this central axis. And this is specific for LEDs. It has some advantages and disadvantages. Dr. Nisa Khan has spoken a lot about the latter. There's going to be a couple of links in the video description. But so let's look at how this looks like in practice in a projector headlamp, for example. The isotropic light intensity, which is output by a curved surface, so a halogen or HID source, reaches the projector lens quite uniformly, so that in the center of the lens we're going to find slightly greater intensity than at the edge of the lens, but the difference is very small. So overall, we have a very uniform light intensity distribution when we look at the lamp from the front. Not so with LEDs. As we've seen, the flat surface of the LED chip emits light, which is already a beam, and it has high peak luminance in the center. So if we look at the cross-section, how it looks like on the projector lens in front of the lamp, it's going to create a bright spot in the center and much, much less light towards the edge of the lens. Now again, this has nothing to do with the power of the lamp or how the beam pattern looks like. Through freeform optics and additional optical elements, so An actual lamp is more complex than this schematic image, of course. There are also reflective optical elements and freeform optics, which are there to produce any kind of beam pattern on the road from either of these two structures. However, they do not change this basic principle and how the light intensity looks like on the projector lens. And more interestingly, this difference and the relative lack of uniformity and the higher peak luminance of the LEDs across the luminous surface is also not picked up by the measurement tools used to estimate and to regulate glare. So all else being equal, because of this high peak luminance, LEDs will be more glaring. And this is the core of the story, but there's just one more little thing, and that is that unless the lamp is very far away, our visual system can pick up on this Gaussian-like bump function intensity distribution, and we know it from basic psychophysics experiment that it interprets that as a trigger for an aversion response, which is there most likely to help us avoid looking directly into the sun. And because of this, the center of this light source, the highest luminance in the center, is going to be perceived as even brighter than it is. So here, for instance, if you look at the headlight of this car, most likely you see it as brighter than the background of the image, but that's just an illusion. Let's call it an illusion. So actually they are the same luminance. Now one has to note here that any lamp, including a halogen headlamp for instance, is going to create a Gaussian-like intensity distribution on the retina, because if for no other reason, because of light also scattering within the eye. I'm going to speak more about this in the next video. However, from any distance where the size of the lamp can be resolved by the eye, this bump function-like intensity distribution already at the lamp is most likely going to increase this effect, thereby these lamps will be perceived as brighter. So, to sum it up, saying that it's necessary to have more glare for greater road illumination is just simply not true. The situation is not so simple. Over the years, we've seen that total flux of headlamps have increased and the sizes of headlamps have decreased, both of these increasing luminance and thereby increasing glare. More interestingly, LEDs introduced a different light intensity distribution, which leads to high peak luminance, further driving glare up, all else being equal. And this intensity distribution is also perceived by our visual system as more glaring or brighter because of an intrinsic aversion response that we have to such Gaussian-like intensity distributions. Now, in the next video, I'm going to speak about how the spectral composition of LEDs further contributes to the glare issues. So, until then, and thank you for watching.